So Mahe Drysdale of New Zealand has a world best time. Tim Mayans of Belgium, an Olympic best time. But Mayans is not in this final. Drysdale very definitely is. And I wonder if we could have consecutive gold medal performances here today for New Zealand. In lane one will be Marcel Hacker of Germany. In lane two, Alexander Alexandrov of Azerbaijan. But first we look at Hacker, the 35-year-old, a bronze medalist in Sydney all those years ago, 12 years ago. In lane two, here he is, Alexander Alexandrov. That's the outsider in this field, 22-year-old from Azerbaijan. In lane three will be the local favourite and hero, Alan Campbell of Great Britain. Is this his moment of destiny? Or could the title go to Lassie Karinen of Sweden in lane four? A favourite maybe, Mahe Drysdale from New Zealand in lane five, 33 years old now, bronze medalist in Beijing. He also carried the nation's flag. And finally in lane six, the other man who is tipped to be the potential winner of the race, Andrei Sinek of the Czech Republic.
Germany,
Azerbaijan, Great Britain, Sweden, New Zealand, and the Czech Republic to battle it out for the gold medal in the men's singles stage final. Last of the day. Campbell likes to get a quick start. Drysdale knows that he must certainly go with his big buddy Campbell. They're best pals and they train together. Excellent style, the first British rower to win a gold medal in the World Cup. Comes from Coleraine in Northern Ireland. Drysdale, of course, a national hero in New Zealand, who's had problems with arthritis and had a bigger problem when he was struck earlier this year on the roads. Just 6 weeks before the London Olympics when he was hit by a car while cycling in Munich. He felt the pain immediately in his right shoulder, ribs and hips. He was favourite to win gold in Beijing as well, but collapsed with dehydration at the end of the race in which he finished third. And Drysdale at this moment may well be third here too. We're coming up towards 500 metres. And Sinek, the other major contender in lane six, may just be ahead. Hacker in lane one has made a good start as well. He's made a good start in all his races. He won his heat very convincingly. The world champion of 10 years ago. Perhaps coming to the back end of his career. As you might say, would be Drysdale at 33, and certainly Karinen also at 36. A pretty even contest as you would expect at the moment, and Drysdale struggling back in fourth place. The lead being contested by Karinen in lane four and Sinek in six. The pack marker of the field in lane two is Alexandrov. I described him as the outsider in the field. Karinen has generally led from the front in all of his races. The Swede who plays the violin, good cross-country skier as well from Breda. And his wife Linda and son Gustav will be watching this race develop. Karinen may be just in the lead, but it's coming up on this lane six, Sinek of the Czech Republic. Silver in Beijing for him as well. His wife Pavla and daughter Alice, no doubt cheering him every step of the way along the lake. The two who are the back markers at the moment are in lane one, Hacker, and in lane two, Alexandrov. Campbell and Karinen just about together, but now Drysdale appears to be making a bit of a move too. Big and powerful men, all well over 6 feet tall. Don't bother competing unless you are. At the halfway stage of the race, we'll get a good indication as to who is hitting the front and who is making a move. Certainly Drysdale appears to be moving a little more sweetly now, and it is going to be Drysdale who will just touch ahead of Sinek. Great rivals these two. 3:30.6 the time for Mahe Drysdale, 1/10 of a second ahead of Sinek in second. New Zealand with two gold medals already in the bag and going for a third here in the shape of Mahe Drysdale, a five-time world champion. We call him Grandpa in the team. He's far from that old. 34 each for stroke rate between the two leaders. Campbell all on if he's going to claim a medal here today for Great Britain. Fifth in Beijing, Alan Campbell. Said he wants to emulate fellow Northern Islanders, the golfers McIlroy, Clark and McDowell have done great things for that country in recent times. But at the moment, Campbell is only pushing up towards third place. He's not troubling the two leaders, who are Mahe Drysdale in lane 5 of New Zealand and Andrej Sinek of the Czech Republic in 6, a sports teacher. Drysdale going through in first here. It's looking good for him at the moment, but he is experienced enough to know there's a lot of rowing to be done yet, and that Sinek is a dangerous customer, a strong finisher. New Zealand 1, Czech Republic 2 on the lake, and the bird takes off as well, right in the eye line of the leader of the race, Drysdale. Now the crowd begins to get excited as they see New Zealand pushing for their second gold of the day and their third with these rowing championships of 2012. It is 33-year-old Mahe Drysdale, 4 years older than Sinek, and in the lead with Karanen of Sweden third, ahead of Campbell of Great Britain. Alexandrov and Hacker are probably out of it now, but Drysdale is heading for home. Roared on as he comes towards the grandstands, and the grandstand finish as well from the Kiwi. Can he add gold to the bronze that's already in the collection? It's looking as though it may well be the day for Mahe Drysdale to pick up a gold medal for himself and for his country. And having seen Murray and Bond, he may have been inspired as well by his fellow Kiwis. Mahe Drysdale leads from Andrej Sinek. They've been great rivals down the years, great friends as well. There's enormous, colossal respect between the rowers in the fraternity. And Mahe Drysdale still heads for home. Sinek will pursue him all the way. Campbell and Karanen are locked in a battle for a bronze medal. Drysdale, the older man. Sinek, can he make youth count? We're getting ever closer to that finishing line, and New Zealand may be about to pick up its second gold medal of this day. It's third of the championships, and what an Olympic Games it is turning out to be for New Zealand here, as Mahe Drysdale comes up to the line ahead of Andrej Sinek. It's gold New Zealand, it's silver Czech Republic, and the bronze will go to Campbell for Great Britain, who just edged out Lassie Karanen. And Great Britain has its third medal of this day, another bronze, but the winner, and a deserving winner as well, Mahe Drysdale, 6:57.82. And let him enjoy his moment. Sinek was good, but not quite good enough to catch the old boy, Grandad. The new Olympic champion, Mahe Drysdale of New Zealand. And Alan Campbell here gets the bronze for Great Britain. The two of them split by the Czech Republic, Sinek. Sinek, who beat Campbell into second place in the semi-final, and has just established the superiority over him again here today. Well, it's tremendously hard work out there on a lake when you're all by yourself with a couple of oars in your hand. Coordination required, courage required, and Mahe Drysdale has both in abundance. But what a super day's racing again. And what a magnificent effort from New Zealand. Turning out to be their best day for many a year. They did pick up medals 4 years ago in Beijing, but now Mahe Drysdale has the gold to that one by Eric Merry and Hamish Bond. And of course Nathan Cohen and Joseph Sullivan also took gold in these championships. So Drysdale confirmed as the winner, around about 2 seconds ahead of Sinek, with Campbell snatching the bronze from Karen and Phil. Alexandrov is fourth for Azerbaijan, Akers sixth for Germany.